الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى متحدثا عن نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم قائلا يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا الله عز وجل in this ayat as other ayat also in the Quran الكريم talking about our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم saying O Prophet this is the first part Allah عز وجل always call our messenger يا أيها النبي or يا أيها الرسول look Allah عز وجل himself calling him with a way of respect يا أيها النبي أو Prophet يا أيها الرسول أو Messenger of Allah عز وجل إنا أرسلناك شاهدا we send you as شاهد witness ومبشرة a bearer of a glad tidings whole Islam is a glad tidings for us the system if we follow it we will be the most successful one we will be at the top and Allah send the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم for us to be the most successful one if we follow and be truthful when we follow. شاهدا مبشرا not only مبشرا bearer of glad tidings ونذيرا and a warner also. A warner that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He is merciful have the Jannah. A warner against the Jahannam, against the Nar, against committing haram. وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه and a caller for Allah Azza wa Jal Call the people for Allah Azza wa Jal by the leave of Allah, by the permission of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَدَاعِيًا إِلَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا And a lamp spreading light. Allah Azza wa Jal describing Rasulullah as a lamp. Light. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Spreading light. And my khutab inshaAllah about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم will be about the perfect and the complete beauty and handsome of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How he sallallahu alaihi wasallam looks, the perfect qualities and the perfect attributes of the body, with in Arabic khalq and khuluq. Khalq, the creation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Creation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How his face looks, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How his head looks. How his hair, does it come to the ear or to the middle of the neck or to the shoulder? About the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The white beard or the white hair of his beard sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The seal of the messengers, khatam al-nubuwa. How is his hand, how is his legs sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is khalq, khuluq. The qualities, the best qualities of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as all of it is the best sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The characteristics of Rasulullah ﷺ, the noble personality and the noble features of Rasulullah ﷺ. But before that, I love to go on with a journey about the full name of Rasulullah ﷺ and we learn some from it. And how many names Rasulullah ﷺ, as some of us thinking that Rasulullah have 99 names. No. What's the meaning of the name Muhammad? What is the meaning of it? And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for him Muhammad? Also, صِفَةُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْبِشَارَاتُ بِهِ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ Description of Rasulullah not only in the Quran, not only in the Sunnah, not by the Sahaba. It is even in the Torah and Injil before. Also, what is the difference between the meaning of the name Muhammad and the meaning of the name Ahmad? We will go on with that, not in this khutbah. It is a series about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wasfu Sayyidina Ali, description of Sayyidina Ali to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. About his kids, how many one of them, and what the names of them. About the uncles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And about the aunts of Rasulullah, how many of them total. About the writers of Rasulullah, when he says the wahi. Some of the Sahaba, very famous, that this is the writers of Rasulullah in wahi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How many muazzin? Is it only Bilal? No, there is many others, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is my journey about Rasulullah. Then, after that, we'll go about khasa'isul nabi. There is some, not only about the character and the very best qualities of Rasulullah, there is some special things was for Rasulullah only, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this is not now. We ask Allah by His great name. I'm saying it clear, not qualified to describe Rasulullah. But I'm asking Allah by His great name, from the member of Rasulullah, to give me tawfiq and to make it easy for me to, because I'm talking about who? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With this weak language, my own, and also with lack of knowledge, for that I'm asking Allah to give me tawfiq and ask Allah to accept whatever right and ask Allah to forgive me whatever any mistake in it. Amen ya Rabbil Alameen. Let us firstly to go on with the full name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Full name, which it is a lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in al-Bukhari, Kitab al-Fada'il, Zad al-Ma'ad ibn al-Qayyim, in Book of al-Siyar Lot, Muhammad ibn Abdillah ibn Abd al-Muttalib ibn Hashim ibn Abd Manaf ibn Qusay ibn Kilab ibn Murrah ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay ibn Ghalib ibn Fahr ibn Malik ibn Nadar ibn Kunanata ibn Khuzaymata ibn Mudrikata ibn Ilyas ibn Mudar ibn Nazar ibn Ma'd ibn Adnan. And enough till here, 21 of them. What we learn from that, and this is very important to brother Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his father is Abdullah. Father of Abdullah is Abd al-Muttalib. Good. Father of Abd al-Muttalib, Hashim. For that, look to the name of Rasulullah, Muhammad. His father is Abdullah Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Ibn means son of. Abdullah, his father is Abd al-Muttalib, Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Abd al-Muttalib. This is what should our name should be. Should be your name first, your father name after that, then father of your father, which it is grandfather for you, and going on. What I found was some of us, and you should correct it. You'll find the middle name for some of the people, anything. Brothers, they are brothers for the same father, and this is have one name, the other one have different name, the third one, subhanallah. Look to your messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jal say in the Quran al-Kareem, Udu'uhum li'aba'ihim. Every single one of us must be called by his father name. Your name, then your father name, third one, grandfather, which it is father of your father, father of the father of the father, and going on. Rasulullah Muhammad, his father Abdullah, becomes son of Abdullah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah. This is, they will say to you, Arab way. No, Islamic way. As Rasulullah did it, will be in Islam. Otherwise, he will allow everybody to do name whatever you want to name. Middle name of yours should be your father. The one after that, your grandfather. Then family name if you want. Because you will not do all of that. Now is not allowed. Your father, your name, father name, for also the family, the kids, all of them should be named with the same father. Amazing that you find the father is Muhammad, and he has son Ahmad and Ali. You will find them, Ahmad is Sayyid, and Muhammad Mahmoud. Where is your father? the way is should be father is the second one after your name right away. Then after that, family name, whatever it is. This if you want to make it short, you want to make it long, then as Rasulullah. Abdul Muttalib, his father is Hashim. He does not become Abdul Manaf. Does not be Abdul Muttalib ibn Abdul Manaf. Abdul Muttalib ibn Hashim and Hashim ibn Abdul Manaf. Abdul Manaf is his son of Ibn Qusay, son of Ibn Kilab, Ibn Mur, and going on. This is the way. Second thing in this point. Then I'll move. Our wives should be named by her own father. Should not be named by your name. Why? For your name, why? Did Rasulullah ﷺ name any one of his wives? 9 or 10 or 11, about the difference between ulama. By his name? Impossible. No one of them. He changed. Some of the wives of Rasulullah, her father was the enemy of Rasulullah, the worst of the enemy of Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he married the daughter, does he change her name? Say, look, your father is my enemy. Leave him alone. Name by my name. Never. ادعوهم لآبائهم. Everybody should be called by his father name. And amazing that here, disrespect for the woman. When you name her by your name, you die, she marry another one, change her name to his name, he divorce her, change the third one. What is that? Is that a joke? Islam respects the ladies. Islam respects the women. For that, this is everyone, and Allah will account you about that. Allah will account, this is the system of Islam. Allah will account us about this point. Another thing, for the people who always fear from everything, the law allow you to keep her name, there is no problem with that at all. Let us move to the second one. In al-Bukhari ma'al Fath, volume number 6, hadith number 3532 and 4896 in Muslim Nawawi, volume 14, 2354, والبيهقي في الدلال and others. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لي خمسة أسماء. I have 5 names. Very clear. Do you know Rasulullah more than him? Answer me. Do you know Rasulullah more than himself about himself? No. He's saying 5. You have to believe in that, yeah. Some of our own Quran. Open the first page, 99 names for Allah. Open the last page, 99 names for Rasulullah, because they think Rasulullah is equal to Allah. Nobody is equal to Allah. This is number one. Number two, he himself said, I have 5 names, very clear. He said, I am Muhammad, I am Ahmad, I am Al-Mahi, and I explain, I am Al-Hashir, I am Al-Aqib. Very clear, this is the names of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am Muhammad, and I explain Muhammad, inshallah, come. وأنا أحمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم I am أحمد and they'll say what is the difference between both وأنا الماحي قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي يمحو الله بي الكفر الماحي means throw whom in the throw رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم Allah will eliminate كفر وأنا الحاشر قال رسول الله الذي يحشر الناس على قدمي who will be the first to be resurrected the people being resurrected after me الحاشر means the first one will be resurrected Everybody will be resurrected after Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم for that one of his names, Al-Hashiru. وَأَنَا الْعَاقِبُ أَيْ لَا نَبِيَ بَعْدِ يَعْقُوبُنِي صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, there will be no prophet after me. Al-Aqib means I am the last one. This is the names of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Muhammad, Ahmad, Al-Mahi, Al-Hashiru, Al-Aqibu. In another hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, in Muslim, شرح النووي 15, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, And he add another, is not a name, but it is like kunya or like for the nasab of Rasulullah ﷺ. قال أنا محمد وأحمد, which it is mentioned in the first one, والمقفى والحاشر ونبي التوبة ونبي الرحمة. نبي التوبة. In this hadith he does not say my name is نبي التوبة, but it is one of the description of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, نبي التوبة ونبي الرحمة. And Nabi is the one who brings for us tawbah, and Allah accepted. And the one who brings the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the meaning of name Muhammad? Firstly, the most famous name to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Muhammad. وَهُوَ يَتَضَمَّنُ الثَّنَاءُ عَلَى الْمَحْمُودِ وَمَحَبَّتُهُ وَإِجْلَالُهُ وَتَعْظِيمُهُ وَهُوَ إِسْمٌ مَنْقُولٌ مِنَ الْحَمْدِ Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the root word of it, ha-ma-da. Hamada means thankful. Hamada means praising. For that, this is the root word. The root word always in Arabic you go to the three letters of the same word. Muhammad, Hamada. For that, if you look to the Arabic dictionary, in order to find where is Muhammad, go to letter of Ha, then find out Mim and Dal. What is the meaning? Some. I'll go with some of it. That it is praising of the one who named Muhammad or Mahmud or Ahmad means he is praised. This is number one. And he himself is praising Allah. For that Muhammad have two meanings. He praises Allah, for that he is Muhammad. Means he is praising. Because we said Muhammad means he is thankful. Thankful to Allah for that he is Muhammad. And others thankful him and praising him for that he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For that the word Muhammad and the word also Mahmud and Ahmad, names of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that means love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he is praising Allah and people around him, not only people, I will explain more, praising him and thankful to him. And it is way of respect also. A great, he is great in our own eye. For that, but because of kathratu hamdihi lillahi fahuwa Muhammad, because he praise Allah a lot and he is thankful to Allah a lot, for that his name Muhammad, and this is one of the meaning of the name. Also the others praising him and thankful to him, for that he is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he is praised with Allah. Is not he is thankful to Allah, Allah himself praising him, which it is in the Quran, for that he is Muhammad. Muhammad with Allah, and Muhammad with the people, and he is thankful to Allah for that he is Muhammad. Not only with that. He is also Mahmudun indal malaika. He is praised with the angel for that he is Muhammad. Or this is one of the meaning of the name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only with the angels and with Allah, with the messengers. All the messengers, we know the story of Al-Isra' wal-Mi'raj, they praised him. You know, when he go to the first sky, second sky, and everyone was praising sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for that Muhammad, because Allah praised him, angel praising him, all his brothers from the messengers and the prophet, they praising him. Not only that, all Muslims and especially mu'min out of the Muslims, they praising Rasulullah. That this is some of the meaning of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But also because of that name, not because of it exactly, يعني, because of some specific things happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to him and to his ummah, for that also the name Muhammad contains some of the meaning, and because of whatever happened, like what? He's Muhammad and he's Ahmad, because ummatuhu, his nation, Muslims, they are praising Allah. That he is Muhammad, out of his nation, is praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are praising and thankful to Allah about whatever good happened, and also about whatever not good happened. We are praising Allah for that he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salatu ummatihi muftatihatun bilhamd. Every single prayer starts with alhamdulillah, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for that he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His khutbah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all without exception, including khutbah of al-Eid. Except khutbah of al-Eid. No. Including khutbah of al-Eid also. Start with alhamdulillah. Khutbah of Rasulullah. And our khutbah also. And our khutbah start with alhamdulillah. For that Rasulullah Muhammad, because all of his ummah, every single khutbah must start with alhamdulillah. Also Quran start with first surah, and the first ayah, what? Alhamdulillah, praising Allah for that he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ فِي اللَّوْحِ الْمَحْفُوظِ أَنَّ خُلَفَاءَهُ وَأَصْحَابَهُ يَكْتُبُونَ الْمُصْحَفَ مُفْتَتِحًا بِالْحَمْدِ. Written in اللوح المحفوظ, that his khulafa, Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali, and his Sahaba at the time, they will write the Quran start with Alhamdulillah for that he is Muhammad. Not only that, one of the reason of his name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ahmad, one of the meaning of it, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the day of judgment, the flag of Alhamd will be a flag for Alhamd, will be in the hand of For that his name, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he do, Allah will give him a shafa'ah. He will do sajda for Allah Azza wa Jal. He will do sujood for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَحْمَدُ رَبُّهُ بِمَحَامِدٍ يَفْتَحُهَا اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ حِينَ إِذٍ. He will start in this sujood before starting the shafa'ah. Shafa'ah intercession, and have a lot of degrees. I already explained it before. For that, he will do sajda. This sajda will be all of it different kind of hamd to Allah, for that he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only that, we know that he is sahibul maqam al-mahmud. He have a very high praised level. Al-maqam al-mahmud. Who is the owner of al-maqam al-mahmud? No anyone else. Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alladhi yaghbituhu alayhi al-aw bihi al-awwaluna wal-akhirun. For it, a lot of people will be jealous of the high position of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For that he is Muhammad. وَإِذَا قَامَ فِي الْمَقَامِ الْمَحْمُودِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ حَمَدَهُ حِينَئِذٍ أَهْلُ الْمَوْقِفِ كُلُّهُمْ مُسْلِمُهُمْ وَكَافِرُهُمْ أَوَّلُهُمْ وَآخِرُهُمْ إِنْسُهُمْ وَجِنُّهُمْ. When he stand in this place of al-maqam al-mahmud, which Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who prepared it to him and put him in it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal, and sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at that time, whole human being and jinn, Muslim and kafir, first one till the last one, human being and jinn will be praising the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the meaning, one of the meaning and one of the reason of his name, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وهو محمد ومحمود صلى الله عليه وسلم بما ملأ الأرض من الهدى والإيمان والعلم النافع والعمل الصالح وفتح الله به القلوب وكشف به الظلمة وكشف به الظلمة عن أهل الأرض كلهم واستنقذهم من أسر الشيطان ومن الشرك بالله والكفر به والجهل به حتى نال به أتباعه شرف الدنيا والآخرة. He is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you hear the name, must say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every single time, order of Allah in the Quran al-Kareem. He is Muhammad, praise, because he fills the whole land with guidance. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fill our heart with iman. When you follow Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he fills the whole earth with beneficial knowledge, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with righteous good deeds, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah open with him or through him the heart for accepting Allah and for accepting Iman and for accepting Taqwa. Allah removed all kind of darkness and jahalat, jahl and ignorance by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him to let us know about shaitan, to be safe from the shaitan, for that he is praised for that, to be saved from shirk, which Allah will never forgive it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you commit it. Who told us about it? Allah in his book, and Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his sunnah, also saved us from, and clarified to us, kufr, and what it is in order to be far from it. And also, we will get the honor, and we will get the dignity and will be in a high position in front of Allah in dunya and in akhirah if we are real follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For all of this he is Muhammad, praised. وهو محمد بما يحمد عليه من مكارم الأخلاق وكان أعلم الخلق وأعظمهم صلى الله عليه وسلم أمانة وأصدقهم حديثا وأحلمهم وأجودهم وأسخاهم وأشدهم احتمالا وأعظمهم عفوا ومغفرة. He is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because of his khuluq. The best of the khuluq sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You want the highest in order to know when the humanity and any kind of civilization other than Islam, they go up and near to goodness, they will be near to Islam. Because Islam, Allah make it at the top. Every time they are progressing and going up in akhlaq. And this is the khuluq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for that he is Muhammad. A'lamu al-khalq. No one of the human being more knowledgeable than him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The most trustworthy one. Ameen. Even before Islam comes to him, Kuffar of Quraysh, they used to name him As-Sadiq al-Ameen, both. Sadiq, the truthful. Al-Ameen, the most trustworthy one. They used to bring their own very expensive stuff to keep it with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. the most trustworthy one and the most truthful one. Not only that, the one who have a lot of sabr. Study his seerah, you will know how much sabr and patience he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has. The most generous one, for that he is Muhammad. He is very generous. Some people, they don't know about generosity, nothing. And the source of it, to know how to be generous to everyone around you, Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, no one can bear equal to or even near to Rasulullah what he bear and what he face in da'wah. Or that when you have some hardship in da'wah, remember Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will know nothing you face. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam faced a lot in himself, a lot in his family, a lot in the relative, a lot against his sahaba sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was so patient sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For that he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us now, with the timing, we'll go with some of Sifatu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi Tawrah. Description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Tawrah. Narrated in al-Bukhari, our own Muslim book. 4,838 and 2,125. An Ata ibn Yasar, qala laqitu Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As. Ata ibn Yasar said, I meet Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, radiallahu anhu. قلت أخبرني عن صفة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في التوراة. I asked him, he said, please let me know some of the qualities and attributes of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Torah. Is there anything in the Torah? قال أجل. He said, yes. والله إنه لموصوف في التوراة. By Allah, he is described in the Torah. ببعض صفته في القرآن. With some of his description also in the Quran, in Surah Al-Fath. Surah number 48, ayah number 8, and Surah Al-Ahzab, Surah number 33, ayah number 45. Ya ayyuha al-Nabi, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira, O Messenger of Allah Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who send you as shahidan, a witness, wa mubashiran, giver of the glad, giver and bearer of the glad tidings, wa nadhiran, a warner. Qala, equal to it in the Torah. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَحِرْضًا لِلْأُمِّيِّينَ. Same exactly. وَحِرْضًا لِلْأُمِّيِّينَ means a guardian and protector for the illiterate. Guardian for them from hellfire. In the same in the Torah. And also in the Injil coming later, inshallah. And أَنْتَ عَبْدِي وَرَسُولِي سَمَّيْتُكَ الْمُتَوَكِّلِ. You are my slave. You are my worshiper. You are my Rasul. I named you Al-Mutawakkil. I have, this is Allah saying, in the Torah, other than the Quran, I have named you Al-Mutawakkil, the one who trusts and depends upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ بِفَضٍ. This is still ayat of the Torah. As mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, and he said, 4,838, he said, لَيْسَ بِفَضٍ. You are not harsh. وَلَا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ. Not hard. Hearted, your heart is soft, is not hard. ولا غليظ القلب ولا سخاب بالأسواق. You are nor a noise maker and or shout in the markets. ولا يدفع السيئة بالسيئة. You do not do evil, return to those who do evil to you. Some of us, if somebody do little mistake to you, you will make it like equal to a mountain upon him. Rasulullah was not like that. He does not return evil with evil, but he always return evil with good and kindness. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لكن يعفو in the Torah. ولكن يعفو واصفحو. But he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, deal with them with forgiveness and kindness and excuse. أقول قولي هذا وادعو الله وأنتم مؤمنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Going on with the ayat from the Torah. ولن يقبضه الله عن about رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولن يقبضه الله حتى يقيم به الملة العوجاء. Allah will not make him to die till he makes straight the crooked people by making them say لا إله إلا الله. فيفتح بها أعينا عميا وآذانا صما وقلوبا غلفا. Will open with it, with which will be opened blind eyes and deaf ears and enveloped heart. InshaAllah, the next time, if Allah wants, we'll go on with some more ayat from the Torah and the Injil about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before I start from Quran and from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we'll go on with what the difference between the name Muhammad and the meaning of the name Ahmad. Then we'll go on, inshaAllah, in future if Allah wants, how the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks like, how the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks like, how is the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks like? Does the hair of Rasulullah go up till his ear or till the middle of his neck or touch the shoulder? And is there any hadith about that or not? How is the legs? How he walks sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How he talk and when he talk to somebody? How he face him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? A lot, inshallah, coming. We ask Allah by His great name to give us tawfiq. Ameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husn ibadatik ya hayyu ya qayyum. اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. وانصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم قو إيماننا وارفع درجاتنا وتقبل صلاتنا واغفر خطيئتنا يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي زادعيت به جبت اجعلنا متبعين لا مبتدعين يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم اجعلنا متبعين لنبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم لا مبتدعين يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم زد حب اللهم زد الحب في قلوبنا له يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة ومن قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. وصلى اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزانا وجزاكم.